Good evening. Please be seated. Good evening, and welcome to our 2023 graduation convocation ceremony. My name is Mr. Oster. I am one of the vice principals at St. Ignatius High School and a former Falcon myself. I am honored to be your master of ceremonies this evening. We would like to begin by acknowledging that we are on the Robinson-Superior 1850 Treaty Area, which is the traditional land of the Anishinaabeg of the Fort William First Nation and other treaty communities on Lake Superior. We want to thank the Indigenous people for taking care of this land and sharing it with us today. We are grateful for the opportunity to live, play, and learn on this land. I would like to introduce Deacon Michael Robinson and his wife Tammy, who will lead us off with the spiritual drumming of the Eagle Song to help us start our new journey.
Hey,
Miigwech, Deacon Michael and Tammy. We are proud of Catholic education in Thunder Bay. Our Catholic school system continues to grow and develop every year. I would like to thank Bishop Frederick Cawley for his ongoing contributions to Catholic education, our community, and welcome him as he joins us for this celebration. At this time, I would like to call upon Bishop Cawley to lead us in prayer. I would ask that you please stand for the prayer and remain standing for O Canada, which will be sung by Blessing Terry Weppy.
Just before I share the prayer with you and the blessing of the graduates, as the Bishop of the Diocese, I take a moment to express my sincere appreciation and gratitude to all those who work in Catholic education, especially in our high schools. To the director, the teachers, the principals, the trustees, the clergy, the support staff, parents, and to everyone who contributes to the cause of Catholic education, I ask God's special blessing upon you. Catholic education is so important to our Catholic community, and it is most evident tonight as we share in this graduation ceremony. Let us always work together to safeguard Catholic education, to make it an even stronger sign of the gospel of Jesus lived out in our lives. Thank you, especially to the parents and the grandparents who are here tonight for these graduates. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Almighty and Creator God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, confident in your love and generosity, we thank you for this special time together. Through Jesus, your Son, we recognize how your grace works within our lives. We ask that you continually guide and direct us in our journey of faith and life. Help us to care for those who are less fortunate and to be ambassadors for Jesus in all that we say and do. We thank you for these graduates, for their families, and those who have brought them to this moment of achievement. Bless them and be with them and guide them in their future works. Keep their hearts and minds in accordance to your will, O Lord. And in sharing their gifts and talents, may they bring you your goodness to others and truly find their way to success and joy in all that they do. We ask this blessing upon them, Lord, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command, car ton bras s'est porté le pays. Il s'est porté la gloire. Ton histoire est une épopée de plus brillants exploits. God keep our land glorious and free. stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you, Blessing. Please be seated. We would like to extend a sincere welcome and thank you to members of our Catholic School Board who have joined us this evening. Mr. Pino Tassoni, Director of Education, Mr. J.P. Tenier, Superintendent of Education, Mrs. Allison Sargent, Superintendent of Education, Mr. Omer Belial, Superintendent of Education, Mr. Brent Mandrick, Superintendent of Business, and Mr. John Power, our Secondary Program Coordinator. As well, we thank our Board Trustees, Mrs. Ash, Ms. Fonzo, Mrs. McFarlane, Ms. Pelche, Mr. Romeo, and Mr. Francis Venerus for their presence this evening. Thank you for being here. Graduates, as you celebrate this milestone in your life and look towards a new horizon, never forget what has brought you this far. Remember the love and support of your family and friends, and remember all your hard work and dedication. Enjoy your evening. This is your night. At this time, I would like to call upon our principal, Mr. Ryan McWhirter, to address the graduates.
Thank you, Mr. Oster. Most Reverend Bishop Cawley, esteemed guests, parents, colleagues, friends, and graduates, it is with immense pride that I stand before you today as we gather to celebrate the remarkable achievements of our grade 12 students. Graduation marks the culmination of years of hard work, dedication, and perseverance. It is a significant milestone in your lives, and it is an honor for me to address you here this evening. First, I would like to extend my heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2023. Each one of you has demonstrated exceptional growth, not only academically, but also personally. You have embraced challenges, embraced learning, and emerged as resilient individuals ready to embark on the next chapter of your lives. Your accomplishments stand as a testament to your determination, and I have no doubt that all of you will continue to shine brightly in all of your future endeavors. Tonight, as you reflect upon your journey, take a moment to acknowledge the unwavering support of your family, friends, and teachers who have guided and nurtured you throughout many years. They have provided you with a strong foundation and instilled in you the values that will serve as your compass in the years ahead. Take a moment tonight to express gratitude to all of those who have walked alongside you, for they have been instrumental in your success. Graduates, as you prepare to take on new adventures, I encourage you to remember the lessons you have learned at St. Ignatius High School. Your time here has not only equipped you with knowledge, but has also nurtured your critical thinking, creativity, character, and adaptability. You have developed essential skills that will empower you to navigate the ever-changing landscape of the 21st century. Embrace the opportunities that lie ahead, pursue your passions, and continue to challenge yourselves to grow and evolve. As you embark on this new phase of your life, always remain grounded and remember the Catholic values that have come to shape who you are. In a world that can sometimes be turbulent, let integrity, compassion, and empathy guide your actions. Embrace diversity, respect different perspectives, and always strive to be agents of positive change in your communities. Remember that greatness is not measured by your individual achievements, but by the positive impact that you have on others. It is always important to give back, even when life throws you a curveball. As all of you know, life is not always easy. It does not always go the way you want it to. All of you will face hardships and have tough days ahead of you. But when those moments come, remember who you are, that you are loved, and that you have a purpose. Each one of you has the strength and courage to overcome life's difficult moments. And keep in mind, they are only moments. Cherish the good times and keep a good perspective on what really matters. In your life, make it your mission to collect memories, not things. Graduation is always bittersweet, as it marks the end of one chapter and the beginning of another. As you prepare to leave high school, remember that the bonds you have formed here will endure and that you will always have a home at St. Ignatius. Tonight, I offer my sincerest congratulations to our high school's class of 2023. As you step out into the world as graduates, remember you have the power to shape your own destiny and create a brighter tomorrow. As graduates of this amazing school, I know that you will continue to use your value-based upbringing to make positive decisions for the rest of your lives. Make this world a better place because you are a part of it. Dream big, worry small, and do the things you're afraid to do. Once again, congratulations on this remarkable achievement, and I wish you all the very best in your future endeavors. May your journey be filled with success, happiness, and fulfillment. Miigwech, and God bless. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. McWhorter. At this time, I ask that all students in Group A please assemble behind the curtain on the right, Group A. As you can see from your program, many of the students here tonight have worked diligently to qualify for scholarships and awards. These awards have been made possible by the generous support of our community and the School Board's Awards Trust Fund. We are very grateful to all of the contributors and we thank you kindly. These generous donations allow us to acknowledge the hard work and outstanding achievements of our Catholic students. It also provides financial aid to our graduates moving on to post-secondary endeavors. Because of your generosity, we are able to direct awards to as many deserving students as possible. So thank you for your continued contributions and support. We have a number of presentations this evening and believe in giving each student his or her moment of glory. We know that you will understand and we thank you for your anticipated patience. Please feel free to come forward if you wish to take a picture, but we do request that pictures be taken from the side areas. The auditorium staff will direct you to the proper locations. At this time, I would like to invite Mr. Carpino and Ms. Papich to begin these special presentations of scholarships and awards.
Good evening and welcome. We will begin our presentations tonight with presenting the certificates of accomplishments. These will be presented by Mr. McWhorter. Receiving certificates of accomplishments are Mitchell Dupuis, Mitchell will be participating in social programs in the community and will miss his school friends and staff. Mitchell Hakala. Mitchell will be pursuing employment opportunities and participating in community programs. Theron Lester. Th- Theron will be returning to St. Ignatius to prepare to enter the Project Search Program. And last but not least, Haley West. Haley will be returning to St. Ignatius to prepare for post-secondary opportunities. We will now continue with the Awards Trust Fund Awards, Community Awards, and Scholarships. The Award Trust Fund is made available through generous donations from the community donations to the fund and can be easily accessed by our board website. Please refer to the pamphlet inserted in tonight's program. Our first award is the Laura's Award. It is presented by Mrs. A. Traz. And it is awarded to Mitchell Dupuis, Mitchell Hakala, Joshua Julian, Joshua. He's on his way out, he's coming. Maria LaPlante, Theron Lester, and Haley West. This award was instituted by Mrs. Traz's family to celebrate the special gift of her sister Laura. A gift of congratulations is given to the students as they complete their transitions or life skills programs, certificate programs, sorry. The Thunder Bay Blues Society Music Scholarship is presented by Ms. L. Lurie. It is presented to Peyton Douglas. This scholarship is given to a graduating student with the highest grade from a grade 12 music program. John Wheeler Memorial Scholarship, presented by Ms. Zed Yurick, and it is presented to Ethan Athelstein. The scholarship was instituted in memory of John Wheeler, a graduate of St. Patrick High School who had a special interest in science and mathematics. It is awarded to honor graduating students in mathematics and science programs who intend to continue their studies at university. The Hugh Wood Award, presented by Ms. M. Jung, it is presented to Maya Venn. Hugh Wood is a retired educator who wants to encourage and support graduating students entering a post-secondary program at the college level. Anthony Boneka Memorial Award. This award will be presented by Anthony's uncle, Mr. Frank Valente. It is awarded to Nicholas Biesenthal. Corporal Anthony Boneka was a St. Ignatius High School graduate and proud Canadian soldier who was killed in the line of duty in 2006 in Afghanistan. This award will be given to a student who best personifies the qualities that made Tony the person he is, or was, a strong Christian leader who displayed a genuine desire to help others. He was committed to school, community, had a big heart, courageous, and very cheerful. The Lily Gibb Memorial Award is presented by Mr. David Gibb. The award goes to Ella Kyoto. This is awarded to a student who is sensitive and kind to others. Preference is given to a student entering education. The Beatrice Bosch Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. R. Bosch, and it is awarded to April Burridge. This award is presented annually in memory of Beatrice Bosch, a teacher, guidance counselor, and former student and athlete at St. Ignatius High School. B exemplified courage, strength, and faith. B had a great perspective on life. She never complained and always put her family and her students before her own. Travis Michael Gertuga Memorial Award will be presented by Ms. M. Gertuga and Juliet Macy. It is awarded to Olivia Holland. This award will be presented annually in memory of Travis Gertuga, a previous graduate of St. Ignatius High School. While talented at many things, Travis loved welding and began a welding apprenticeship and career following high school. This award will be presented to a graduating student of St. Ignatius High School who has been accepted into the trades program at Confederation College. The recipient of this award should exemplify Travis's passion and dedication to a trade, but more importantly, his kindness, compassion, and willingness to help others. Partners in Rehab Frank Finch Memorial Award is presented by Dr. Pontello and is awarded to Katrina Long. This award was established by Partners in Rehab in memory of Frank Finch, who worked with this company in business development. It is awarded to a deserving student who demonstrates academic excellence, compassion, empathy for others, and is pursuing a career in rehabilitation rehab. Michael Vita Memorial Awards will be presented by Ms. Lena Vita and is awarded to Kirsten Buchholz and Sarah Mann. This award will be presented annually in memory of Michael Vita, a student who graduated from St. Ignatius High School. After his graduation, Michael was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. And throughout the next 8 years, he exemplified courage, strength, and faith. Michael had a great perspective on life. He never complained, and he continued to smile throughout the years. The Frank Padula Memorial Award is presented by Miss Maria Padula, and it's presented to Michael Arnone. This award is presented in memory of Frank Padula to honor his dedicated work ethic, commitment to his family and the community, and admiration for continuing education. The recipient of this award is a hardworking student who has demonstrated great strength in character and compassion towards others. The Dallas Bailey Memorial Award. It will be presented tonight by Ms. Alfonso. It will be presented to Brock McKenzie. This award is presented in memory of Dallas, a former St. Ignatius student. The recipient of this award is a hardworking, goal-oriented student who demonstrates school commitment, who is involved in the community and or school-based athletics, and who will be entering the trades program after high school. The next two awards will be presented by Ms. C. Krupe. The Eva Sacchetti Memorial Award will be presented to Megan Choney and Peyton Douglas. This award was created to remember the life of Eva Sacchetti and to continue her legacy of wisdom, integrity, loyalty, generosity, gentleness, thoughtfulness, and service to others. The ideal recipient will embody those same principles and shall be involved in a balance of community, school, volunteer, and church activities. Ms. Krupe will also be presenting the St. Pius X Elementary School Award, and it is awarded to Vincenzo Fabiano. This is awarded to a former student of the school who is now graduating from St. Ignatius and demonstrates good values, academic achievement, positive attitude towards peers, teachers, and towards learning. The next two awards will be presented by Mr. Jay Pascuzzo. The Peter Pascuzzo Memorial Awards will be presented to Taylor Hayes and Katrina Long. Peter Pascuzzo was a well-known and dedicated teacher with the Thunder Bay Catholic District School Board. This award is presented to graduates who have excelled and contributed significantly to their school program. The Italian Society of Port Arthur Awards will be presented to Sloan Melchiori and Sydney Roberto. These awards were established by the Italian Society of Port Arthur. It honors the sons and daughters of members who have completed 6 URM courses and are continuing on to post-secondary education. The Hugh and Rita Morrow Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. M. Morrow and is awarded to Chloe Millette. This award is presented in memory of Hugh and Rita Morrow to honor their compassion and willingness to help others in need. The recipient must be a graduating student of St. Ignatius High School entering the Personal Support Worker Program at Confederation College. Preference will be given to students who show commitment to helping others. At this time, I would like to ask recipients in Group B to please assemble behind the curtain. The stage will be given to Ezra Koester. The Tom Mustapik Memorial Award will be given by Mrs. C. Mustapik and Mr. M. Mustapik and will be awarded to Jackson Fonzo. Tom Mustapik was a devoted member of the Thunder Bay Catholic School Board community, and he took great pride in coaching the boys' basketball team at St. Ignatius High School for many years. He loved to help students reach their highest potential in academics, athletics, and life. A scholarship has been established in memory of Tom to recognize a graduating St. Ignatius student on the boys' basketball team who shared Tom's values of hard work, dedication, respect, commitment, leadership, and willingness to help others. The next three awards will be presented by Ms. Krista Lagozo Danielli. The Lagozo Awards will be awarded to Megan Arpin, Matthew Iacchetta, Connor Stubbs, and Nicole Lauren. These awards are presented to students who have achieved solid academic success. The Rotary Citizenship Awards are presented to Joseph Foresta and Zoe Power. These awards are presented to students who have good academic achievement, school and community involvement, leadership, and attendance. The recipients of this award are voted on and selected by the staff and students of St. Ignatius High School. Thunder Bay Rotary Clubs and International District 5580 four-way test essay contest, second place winner this year, goes to Kira Meekin. The winner of this contest has been chosen based on her essay composition, which addresses 4 important questions. Is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned? The Thunder Bay District and Labor Council scholarships will be presented by Mr. C. Santura, Santander, Maturana. They are awarded to Alyssa Fabiano and Sloan Melchiori. This scholarship is awarded to members or dependents of a local union affiliated with the Thunder Bay Labor Council, who have demonstrated significant social justice awareness and a strong school and community involvement. The Ed Lozon Athletic Awards will be presented by Mr. M. Douglas, and they are awarded to Moira Menard and Tyler Robinson. These awards are presented to senior physical education students, one male, one female, who have high academic standing and have contributed to the school's athletic program. The Filipino-Canadian Association of Thunder Bay Award, Dr. Anita Chen Memorial Award, will be presented by Mr. Jay Bannister. The award goes to Erich Kabungnison. This scholarship recognizes graduating students entering post-secondary programs who are members of the association that have helped foster Filipino culture in our city while succeeding academically. The Frank Tropea Senior Memorial Awards will be presented by Mr. T. Pacifico. They are presented to Sydney Roberto and Aaron Whipple. This award is presented in memory of Frank Tropea to St. Ignatius Grade 12 graduating student attending college or university. This person must exemplify a strong work ethic, be outgoing and helpful to others, have a great sense of humor, is liked by his or her peers, and contributed significantly to the community. The Superior Rush FC Rep Player Scholarships are presented by Ms. R. Start and Ms. T. Metz. They were presented to Zoe Power and Kaylin Stewart. These awards are presented to students who have been active players within the Superior Rush Football Club and involved in community through volunteer activities and have contributed both academically to their school. The Thunder Bay Veterinary Hospital Award will be presented by Dr. D. Sanzo. And it is awarded to Paige Broughton. This award is presented to a worthy student who will be entering into the animal health care field. Applicants have achieved a minimum combined course average and have demonstrated an interest in animal care. The Ashley Perrier Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. R. Perrier. And it is awarded to Reagan Goddick. This award will be presented annually in memory of Ashley Perrier, who was a student at St. Ignatius in the life skills class. The recipient of this award should exemplify Ashley's special zest for life. Ashley was a person who met any obstacle with a fierce determination and showed no fear. This award will be given to a compassionate and helpful student who is entering the field of social services. Knights of Columbus, Father Regis St. James Council 9295, Brother Rene Gravel Memorial University Scholarship will be presented by Mr. C. Gabrielik. And it is awarded to Nicholas Biesenthal and Karina Gabrielik. Preference for this award is given to the sons, daughters, or grandchildren of members in good standing. Students must demonstrate Christian leadership and demonstrate a significant contribution to school, community, and be accepted to university. Knights of Columbus Leo Council 1130 Award will be presented by Mr. E. Vigen, and it will be awarded to his daughter, Tiana Vigen. This scholarship is awarded to St. Ignatius graduating students who are continuing their education at university. Awards are decided on academics, Christian leadership, overall contribution to school and community activities. Preference is given to the sons and daughters of council members. Jean Suffolk Award will be presented by Ms. L. Fonzo. The recipient this year is Carson Goddard. The award is to be presented to a student entering the information technology field, pursuing an area of study in management information systems, artificial intelligence, computer engineering, computer programming, software engineering, network infrastructure, informatics, data analytics, security, 3D imaging. The Thunder Bay Police Association Sergeant Rick Ferrari Memorial Scholarships will be presented by Sergeant R. Belcamino, Constable S. Lawson, Constable J. Kawapa Aho, and Sergeant S. Whipple. The recipients of this award is Tia Belcamino, Haley Lawson, Noah and Zoe Power, and Aaron Whipple. This award is given to sons and daughters of members of the Thunder Bay Police Association who are proceeding to post-secondary education and who have shown qualities of leadership and service in the school and the community. Thank you. The next two awards will be presented by Mr. D. Berry. The Thunder Bay Chamber of Commerce Women in Trade Scholarship will be awarded to Caitlin Bueller. This award honors female high school graduates who are pursuing and attending post-secondary programming in a trade program. The Resolute Forest Products Thunder Bay Operations Scholarship will be presented to Sydney Roberto and Aaron Whipple. This award is presented to a graduating student continuing his or her education at the college or university level who has a minimum academic average in grade 11 and 12 courses and who provides evidence of good sportsmanship and leadership. The next six awards are from the Thunder Bay Community Foundation Scholarships and Bursaries Program. The successful applicants of these scholarships and bursaries are given to outstanding students who have demonstrated a high level of academic achievement, coupled with participation in other activities in school, the community, athletics, or special events. The Thunder Bay Community Auditorium Performing Arts Award will be presented by Ms. S. Lester and will be awarded to Katie Como. This award is given to a student who is entering a post-secondary program continuing in the performing arts. The Justice Ronald Lester Memorial Bursaries will be presented by Ms. Lester, as well, to April Burridge and Jet Schweitzer. This award is presented to a student, to students in their graduating year who would benefit from this bursary in aiding their post-secondary pursuits. The next three awards are presented by Ms. Wendy Bell. The Helen L. Dewar Scholarship is presented to Ethan Asselstein. This scholarship is awarded to students who attain a minimum overall average of 80% and who will be attending a full-time studies at a Canadian university. June Morgan McDonald Bursary for Fine Arts will be presented to Katie Como. This scholarship is awarded to students who attain a minimum overall average of 80% and who will be attending full-time studies at a Canadian university. The Victor Stevenson Aircraft Engineering Technology Scholarship will be presented to Myla Lawson and Sydney Roberto. This scholarship is awarded to students who attain a minimum of 80% overall average and who will be attending a full-time studies in an engineering or aviation program at a Canadian or college or university. The Superior North EMS Leslie Vance Bursary will be presented by Mr. Jay Gale. It'll be awarded to Jet Schweitzer. This award is awarded to students entering the paramedic or other healthcare programs at college or university. The criteria requires students to have academic performance and community involvement. At this time, I would like to ask recipients in Group C to please assemble behind the curtain to stage right. The Lucy Migliazza Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. J. Migliazza and Ms. L. Migliazza. And it is awarded to niece and sister Kira Migliazza. This award is presented to a student of St. Ignatius High School who demonstrates student leadership and who is continuing his or her education in the health science profession. Dr. Donald Power Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. J. Power. It is awarded to Madison Blackwood. This award is presented in memory of Dr. Donald Power to a deserving student who has maintained a minimum B average, displayed a positive Christian attitude, made contributions to their school, community, and will be continuing his or her education at the university level. The Tim McFarlane Memorial Award will be presented by Mrs. D. McFarlane, Mrs. K. Shibulvik, and Mr. S. McFarlane. It is awarded to Blessing Terwepi. This award is presented in memory of Tim McFarlane, an inspirational teacher who taught at the intermediate level in the Catholic system. Tim had a passion for his profession, which was felt by his students and colleagues on a daily basis. With a love of the English language, Tim's words, both written and spoken, always made a person feel special, welcome, and respected. The Jack Kopp Memorial Award will be presented by Madame G. Serlano. It is presented to Sarah Bottenfield. This award is presented in memory of Jack Kopp, a dedicated teacher and longtime principal with our school board. This award goes to a student who has participated in at least two extracurricular activities and pursuing a career in education. The Ellen LaFroy Memorial Award is presented by Mr. T. Romeo. And it is awarded to Kaylee Koch. This award is presented to a student who best exemplifies the humanitarian characteristics so important to Ellen, a former teacher with our board. The recipient is a lively, cheerful, outgoing person who shows determination and great concern for others. The Fran McDonald Memorial Award is presented by Mr. T. Romeo. It is awarded to Madison Hanlon Smith. This award is for a graduate who has assisted in school activities and who will continue his or her studies in post-secondary education. George Kozak Memorial Award will be presented by Ms. P. Del Paggio and is presented to Reagan Goddick. This award goes to a student who is entering the field of social work or related studies at Confederation College or Lakehead University. The Patricia Barber Memorial Award will be presented by Mrs. C. Corbett, and it is awarded to Olivia Verardo. This is awarded to a student continuing his or her studies in post-secondary education. The student should have strong volunteer background demonstrating community service to the poor. The next two awards will be presented by Ms. A. Vigen. The St. Anthony's Holy Name Society Awards and the St. Anthony's Parish Catholic Women's League Awards will be presented to Caleb Cochemilio and Tiana Vigen. These awards go to deserving parish members who are graduating and continuing on to post-secondary studies. Criteria includes good academic performance, regular attendance, and active participation in school, community, and at the parish level. J. Bernard Baxter Award will be presented by Ms. S. Vidotto to Rhea Scully. This award is given to our top grade 12 University English student. The Thunder Bay Minor Hockey Association Alex Moe Irving Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Mr. O. Belisle, and is awarded to Ethan Friesen. This scholarship is presented to students with high academic standing who are continuing their education in post-secondary studies, have played hockey for at least 4 years in the Thunder Bay Minor Hockey Association. Blair Haggerty Aikens Memorial Awards will be presented by Ms. D. Aikens and Mrs. F. Morrill. They are awarded to Ethan Fell, Caden Halstead, TJ Hill, Logan Morrill, Eric Sandell, and Marcus Zeppatelli. This award will be presented to a graduating student of St. Ignatius that have been accepted into trades programs at Confederation College for the 2023-24 school year. The recipients must have demonstrated respect for staff and have been supportive of his or her peers throughout their high school career. Sister Bernadette Kinsella Memorial Award will be presented by Ms. Jay LaCaria. This year's award goes to Isabella Neves. This award is presented to a student who participates in religious education class and in practice demonstrates diligence, responsibility, effort, and high standard of achievement in the Christian Living Program. The Helen Barbini Anderson Memorial Award will be presented by Ms. L. Foster, and it is awarded to Ezra Koester. This award is presented to a student who has maintained good grades and has displayed positive Christian attitude. Preference is given to students entering programs pertaining to social work. Jeffrey Bentz Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. P. Rozon, and is awarded to Madison Peterson. This award is presented to a graduating student from St. Ignatius High School who is continuing his or her studies at university or the college. The recipient will have shown high level of participation in citizenship, in the school, and in the community. The Carlo Capello Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. J.P. Tenier, and it is awarded to Thomas Sousa. This award is presented to a student who has achieved high academic standing in the Senior Technology Studies program. Don McKinnon Memorial Award, presented by Ms. T. Yoni to Cora Taipali. This award is presented to a student who has participated and made significant contribution in music, art, drama, and dance performance. Olga Mahalis Memorial Award, presented by Ms. S. Vidotto, and is awarded to Lucy Felsigno. This is awarded to a graduating student with preference given to a student pursuing a career in the medical field. The Patrick Duchak Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. M. Furtado, and it will be awarded to Chad Smith. Patrick was a student at St. Ignatius High School who went on to study mechanical engineering at Lakehead University. This award was created in loving memory of Patrick and is awarded to a student who has participated in high school or community sports and has appreciation for the outdoors. The Loretta Sutil Memorial Award, presented by Mrs. E. Ash, and is awarded to Sierra Fidel. This is awarded to a graduate who has contributed unselfishly to the well-being of others. Phil Pelche Memorial Award will be presented by Ms. S. Pelche. It is awarded to Olivia Dupuis. The Phil Pelche Memorial Award is given to in honor of Phil Pelche, who served as a trustee for Thunder Bay Catholic District School Board for over 25 years. He was instrumental in many of the school board's Indigenous education initiatives, especially the Ojibwe language programs, and spoke for equity, anti-racism, and alternative learning for students. He is remembered for his kindness and witty sense of humor. This award is given to an Indigenous student attending post-secondary education who demonstrates the values of the seven grandfather teachings: love, wisdom, bravery, respect, humility, honesty, and truth. Deacon Bill McKinnon Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. M. McDermott and is awarded to Lena Kaiser Seasons. This award is presented to students who have overcome obstacles in order to graduate. Julie Pacifico Memorial Award will be presented by Mr. T. Pacifico and is awarded to Taylor Hayes and Lucas Marchese. This award is presented annually in memory of Julie Pacifico, who is an admissions officer with the Northern Ontario School of Medicine. Her work and belief in fairness and equity for everyone has helped to shape and innovate the admissions process for NOSM. Gustavo Argueta Memorial Scholarship will be presented by Mr. F. Ianni, and it is awarded to Nathan Peace. Gustavo was loved by all who met him due to his cheerful and caring disposition. He excelled at many sports, but soccer was his true passion. His dedication to the sport earned him the respect of his teammates and opponents alike. His hard work and commitment also earned him a post-secondary scholarship in the United States. Tragically, at the age of 24, he was taken from his family and community while working at a summer job. This award recognizes exceptional student athletes that are performing well in the classroom and on the soccer field, hoping to continue their soccer career at a university or college. Kiwanis Club of Westford Scholarship will be presented by Mr. P. Rozon and is awarded to Sydney Roberto. This scholarship is granted to students proceeding to post-secondary education who have demonstrated qualities of good citizenship and who have participated in extracurricular and community activities. The next two awards will be presented by Mr. T. Lametti and Ms. D. Ayani. Sister Louise Vanetti Memorial Award, who's the aunt of Tim Lametti and Dennis Ayani, will present to Madison Peterson. This award was instituted by the Catholic Family Development Center and is given to a student who attends to pursue studies in human services at the college or university and who, during his or her high school years, has contributed time and to social justice issues and community building. Madison is also receiving the Ladies of Kalava Anikan Tupa number 255 award. Congratulations. This award is awarded to a student of Finnish descent who will be continuing to post-secondary education. This award is given to a student who has been diligent and industrious in their studies and will demonstrate abilities of teamwork in and outside the classroom. The Knights of Kalava Sampo Maya number 51 award will be presented by Mrs. C. Korpeski. It is awarded to Aiden Helke. The recipient of this award must be of Finnish heritage and continue in his or her education at the college or university level. The Ontario Power Generation Achievement Awards will be presented by Mr. M. DeProfitis. It is awarded to Charlie Barton and Riley Beauregard. These awards go to graduating students who have interest in pursuing their studies with a specific focus in one or some of the following areas: engineering, electronics, science, information technology, environment, or mathematics. The students should have strong oral communication skills. At this time, I would like to ask recipients in Group D to please assemble behind the curtain to stage right.
The Corpus Christi Parish Catholics Women's League Award is presented by Mr. John Cicino to Emma Assestein and Olivia Verardo. This award is based on academic achievement and is given to a son or daughter of a parishioner who is continuing his or her education at the university or college level. The Fort William First Nation Perseverance Award is presented by Mrs. Foster to Maya Miller and Nolan Neal. This award is presented to a graduating student from Fort William First Nations who has shown progress and perseverance in achieving a secondary school diploma. The St. Kateri Takakwitha Bursary is awarded to Bashlyn Quandabins Bashlyn Quandabins Boucher Lagarde by Deacon Michael Robinson and Tammy Robinson. This award is made possible by the Diocese of Thunder Bay Indigenous Ministry Office. This is a new and welcomed award, named by the Elders Council to honor St. Kateri Takakwitha, our first Indigenous saint. This award is to provide and assist an Indigenous student to continue his or her education at a university, college, or trades program of choice. This student is an individual who continues to promote their Indigenous culture and lives daily according to their Indigenous Catholic teachings. The Bryans Award, presented to Vachelin also, Quandabins Boucher Lagarde, was established in loving memory of Brian Wiley. The St. George Society Award is presented by Mrs. Corbett to Mitchell Fell. This award is presented to a graduate of St. Ignatius High School who has achieved a high standing in the grade 12 university-bound religious education course. The St. Margaret's Parish Catholic Women's League Award is presented by Ms. Fidotto to Joshua Karen. This award is presented to an active parish member who has demonstrated a Christian attitude, respects peers and teachers, willingly shares time and talent with others, and exemplifies a positive attitude towards learning. The St. Patrick Cathedral Catholic Women's League and the St. Patrick Cathedral Parish Council Award is presented by Ms. Stickle to Anna Stickle. These awards are made available to parishioners who are actively involved in the church and who have volunteered in the community. The Diabetes Foundation of Canada Scholarship is presented by Mrs. Foglia to Alyssa Fabiano. The Diabetes Scholarship Program highlights the personal triumphs of young adults who face the many responsibilities associated with diabetes management, while significantly enriching their lives through community and extracurricular activities and maintaining a healthy lifestyle. The next two awards will be presented by Mr. Mandrick. The Oceans Capital Company Scholarship is presented to Joseph Foresta. The recipient of this award is the son or daughter of an active member of the Acadia Broadcasting Corporation, has demonstrated academic excellence, community involvement, and an active member of their school community. The Black Excellence Award is presented to Kaden Modi. The recipient is a student of visible African Caribbean descent who shows dedication through academics and activism, and who is proceeding to college or university. The Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association Thunder Bay Elementary Unit Awards is presented by Mr. Shack to Caroline DeFelice and Sydney Roberto. These awards are presented to the son or daughter of an active or retired OECTA member who is continuing his or her own studies at the post-secondary institution and have the highest academic standing in his or her graduating year. The Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association Thunder Bay Secondary Unit is presented by Mrs. Corbett to Katie Como, Anna Stickle, and Olivia Verardo. These awards are presented to the sons or daughters of an active or retired OECTA member who is continuing his or her studies at a post-secondary institution and has the highest academic standing in his or her graduating year. The Thunder Bay Professional Firefighters Local 193 Educational Award is presented by Mr. B. Meekin to Kiara Meekin. Awarded to students to promote the continuing pursuit of high education, this award is presented to a family member of Local 193. The Canadian Office and Professional Employees Union, COPE Local 96, Jack Elbert Award is presented by Ms. T. Falcino to Donovan Manpaw. This award goes to the son or daughter of a COPE Local 96 member and is completing grade 12 with an above average standing and continuing into post-secondary education. The Canadian Office and Professional Employees Union Local 454 Scholarship is presented by Ms. Dee Miller to Destiny Miller. This scholarship is awarded to a grade 12 student with the greatest academic improvement to be used to help further his or her education. Preference is given to sons or daughters of the member of the local COPE 454. The next awards will be presented by Mrs. Alberardi. The Lakehead Japanese Cultural Associate Award is presented to Tyler Robertson. This award is presented to the student who has one or both parents of Japanese ancestors and who are members of good standing in the association and who is proceeding to post-secondary education. The Impact Promotions Award are presented to Hannah Kisik, Kidan Modi, and Achignam Butler. This award recognizes a student who has dealt with and overcome diversity and has made a overcome adversity and who has made a positive impact on the school community. Professional Engineers Ontario Lakehead Chapter Scholarship is presented by Mr. T. Lametti to Myla Lawson. This is awarded to a deserving student that will be studying engineering at Lakehead University in the fall. The St. Ignatius High School Students Council Leadership Award is presented by Ms. Vidotto to Nicholas Biesenthal and Tiana Vigen. This award recognizes the leadership and dedication of an individual participating in school, council, Falcon Force, and the school community. The St. Ignatius High School Hairstyling Aesthetics Award is presented by Mr. Malikala to Horizon Mendewagen. This award is presented to a St. Ignatius student who not only has achieved academic excellence, but also demonstrates a highly developed understanding in the hairstyling industry and plans to pursue a career in this trade. The Phyllis Blumstrom Award is presented by Mr. S. McFarland to Grace Fitzpatrick. This award is for a student who is hardworking and demonstrates persistence and dedication to improving his or her math skills. The Bill and Susan Tenier Award is presented by Mr. J.P. Tenier to Riley Beauregard. Bill and Susan Tenier Award is given in honor of Bill and Susan Tenier, advocates for Catholic education and volunteerism in the community. Bill Tenier's career with the Thunder Bay Catholic District School Board spent 29 years, culminating as the Director of Education. Susan is a retired teacher who taught mathematics at both St. Patrick's and St. Ignatius High Schools. This award is given to a student with strong academic achievement who is attending post-secondary studies and has demonstrated a commitment to volunteering their time for others. The Catholic Principals Council of Thunder Bay Awards is presented by Mrs. A. Sargent. This award is presented to Lucas Marchese and Adam Strickland. This award is based on a combination of academics and strong contribution to the building of a Catholic community within the school. Preference is given to a son or daughter of a member. The Agape Achievement Award is presented by Mrs. Corbett to Maria LaPlante. This award is presented to a graduate who is continuing post-secondary college studies. The recipient should actively demonstrate positive discipleship qualities and friendliness, compassion, and reliability. At this time, I ask Group E to assemble behind the curtains to your right. Group E. The Trustee Award. The Trustee Award is presented by Mr. L. Badani to Abigail Pilon. Thank you, Mr. Benaruz. This award is provided by the Thunder Bay Catholic District School Board Trustees and is presented to a graduate who has shown significant improvement in their academics. St. Ignatius High School Communication Technology Awards is presented by Mr. M. Iani to Nicholas Biesenthal and Cora Taipale. This award is presented to a St. Ignatius student that has achieved academic excellence in the Communication Technology Grade 12 course. The Portuguese Association of Thunder Bay Awards is presented by Mr. Furtado to Isabella Neves and Thomas Sousa. These are awarded to graduating students of Portuguese descent with parents and or grandparents as members. Students must have good academic standing, good work ethic, participate in extracurricular activities, demonstrate community involvement, and be continuing their studies at the post-secondary level. The Zuliani Family Award is presented by Madame Salerno to Megan Arpin. This award is presented to a student who has made contributions both to our school and our community. The next two awards will be presented by Ms. Jay Lacaria. The Lieutenant Governor's Community Involvement Award is presented to Gerline Boulard. The recipient of this award is a graduating student who has contributed significantly to his or her community by volunteering. The Catholic Student Award is presented to Tiana Vigen. This award goes to a student who demonstrates Christian values and has made significant contributions to the community and to the school. The Life Touch Valedictorian Award is presented by Mr. R. McWhorter to Chad Smith. This award is presented to our graduating class's valedictorian. The next award is a late entry, is not in the program. It's the City of Thunder Bay Association Civic Management Employees Scholarship Award, and it's presented by Mrs. Sabrina Peterson to Moira Menard. This award is presented to children or dependents of current Association of Civic Management Employees and is based on the highest academic achievement and must be enrolling in a recognized post-secondary education program. The next two awards are presented by Bishop Freda Colley to students who display faith leadership at the school and parish level, have a high level of academic achievement, and participate in extracurricular activities. The Bishop Norman Gallagher Outstanding Student Award is presented to Joseph Foresta. The Bishop John O'Mara Outstanding Student Award is presented to Fernanda Soto Valenzuela. Thank you, Bishop. We now move to the Confederation College Scholarships and Awards. The next two awards will be presented by Red River Ward Councillor Michael Zucino. These awards honor students who have strong academic standing, commitment to school and community, and attending Confederation College. The City of Thunder Bay Entrance Scholarship is awarded to Caitlin Bueller. The City of Thunder Bay Entrance Award is presented to Olivia Holland. The next two awards were presented by Ms. E. McRae to students planning to attend Confederation College in September. Confederation College Early Entrance Scholarships awarded to Carson Goddard and Lydia Rocco. The Confederation College Grade 11 Early Acceptance Awards are presented to Vashon Quandabins Boucher Lagarde, Chloe Millette, and Lydia Rocco. Group F, to your right, please. Group F, to your right. The Thunder Bay Catholic District School Board Awards Trust Fund Confederation College Entrance Award are presented by Mr. Jay Power. These awards are presented to Morgan Ballin, Natalia Fortino, Jackson Fonzo, Carson Goddard, Jory Hay, Isabel Hayden, David Iwanishin, Sierra Okerlund, Emily Paulo, and Eric Sundell. These awards are given to students of St. Ignatius High School on the basis of academic achievement, demonstrated leadership, participation in the high school and community activities, and overall contribution to our school. Thank you. I will now call upon Dr. David Richards, Dean of Business Administration, to present the Lakehead University Awards and Scholarships. We will begin with the Northern Ontario and Simcoe County Citizenship Scholarship. This award is given to a nominated student who has a minimum of 85% average in grade 12 courses, who models good citizenship with his or her community, and who will be attending Lakehead University. This year it is awarded to Fernanda Soto Valenzuela. The Entrance Scholarship of Academic Excellence. This award is given to students that have achieved a minimum of overall average of 95%. The average is based on grade 12 URM marks. This year it's awarded to Ethan Asselstein, Esteban Christofferson, Mitchell Fell, Nicole Lauren, and Myla Lawson. The Academic Entrance Scholarship. These awards are given to students attending Lakehead University for their academic achievement and are based on their best six U and M courses averaging 80% or higher. Final semester one marks and second semester midterm marks are used in the calculations. Charlie Barton. Riley Beauregard. Tia Belcamino. Nick Biesenthal. Madison Blackwood. Edric Bileski. Achignam Butler. Josh Caron. Megan Choney. Katie Como. Christopher Coppola. Grace DeProfitis. Peyton Douglas. At this time, I ask Group G to go to the right, please. Ethan Dill. Alyssa Fabiano. Lucy Fabiano. Lucy Falsino. Maya Ferris. Joseph Foresta. Jared Francoeur. Ethan Friesen. Paige Fusile, Karina Gabriluk, Jordan Graham, Taylor Hayes, Julia Hunter, Emmanuel Hurtubise, Raleigh Johnston, Ezra Kester, Myla Lawson, Katrina Long, Donovan Manpaw, Sarah Mann, Jenna Mazan, Abigail Mazuka, Kenna McCurry, Kira Meekin, Moira Menard, Kira Migliazza, Jordan Humanick, Isabella Neves, Madison Peterson, Dante Riccio, Mohammed Shabana, Chad Smith, Lincoln Smiley, Fernanda Soto Valenzuela, Kaylin Stewart, Victoria Stray, Alyssa Sullivan, Cora Taipala, Nadia Tozo, Mariana Vargas Gonzalez, sorry, Mariana. Olivia Verardo. Tiana Vigen. Aaron Whipple. The next set of presentations will be made by Mr. F. Benaruz. These awards are presented to students who are recipients of scholarships and bursaries from out-of-town colleges. The Brock University Scholars Entrance Award is awarded to April Burridge. The Humber College Athletic Entrance Scholarship is awarded to Brock McKenzie. The King's University Simona Mascant Scholarship is awarded to Nathan Peace. The Lakehead University Athletic Entrance Scholarship for basketball is awarded to Alyssa Kreiner and Jackson Lawrence. The Nipissing University Schulich Entrance Scholarship is awarded to Caitlin Ezard. The St. Francis Xavier University Athletic Entrance Scholarship for soccer is awarded to Zoe Power. The Toronto Metropolitan Academic Entrance Scholarship is awarded to Kaden Modi. The University of Guelph Academic Entrance Scholarship is awarded to Kirsten Buchholz. The University of Ottawa Academic Entrance Scholarship is awarded to Emily Cullinan and Sydney Roberto. The University of Toronto Faculty of Applied Science and Engineering Scholarship and the Edward S. Rogers Senior Admission Scholarship is awarded to Matthew Yaketa. The University of Waterloo President Scholarship of Distinction is awarded to Rhea Scully and Connor Stubbs. The Western University Academic Distinction Scholarship is awarded to Sloan Melchiori. I think we're done. Thank you. St. Ignatius High School Medal Awards will be presented by Mr. Pete Tassoni. Mr. Tassoni, we're going to get you to do an extra one. The University of Toronto Scholarship for Football is awarded to Jet Schweitzer. The St. Ignatius High School Medal Awards. All medal recipients must be in their graduating year. This is for the Academic Medal Awards. The Workplace Preparation Program medals are based on a combination of 6 senior workplace courses, one of which must be English 4E. The College Preparation Program medals are based on the highest academic standing in a combination of 4 grade 12 C courses, one of which must be English 4C, and 2 additional senior C or M courses. And the University Preparation Program medals are based on the highest academic standing on a combination of the highest 6 U and or M courses, one of which must be English. The College Preparation Bronze Medal goes to McKenna Christie. The University Preparation Bronze Medal is awarded to Kirsten Buchholz. The College Preparation Silver Medal is awarded to Isaac Hill. Thank you. The University Preparation Silver Medal is awarded to Ethan Aselstein. The Workplace Preparation Gold Medal is awarded to Nolan Neal. The College Preparation Gold Medal is awarded to Thomas Sousa. And the University Preparation Gold Medal is awarded to Rhea Scully. Thank you, Mr. Tassoni. And I'll turn it back to Mr. Ianni, I think. Oh, Mr. Oster.
Thank you, Mr. Carpino and Ms. Papich, and a sincere congratulations to all of our award winners for their excellent work. Now, the moment you've been waiting for. Graduates, your walk across the stage is to celebrate you and your accomplishments. I would like to ask our Director of Education, Mr. Pino Tassoni, and the principal of St. Ignatius High School, Mr. Ryan McWhorter, to come forth for the presentation of the diplomas and certificates. And I would like to call upon Mr. Carpino and Ms. Papich once again to announce our 2023 potential graduates.
Marshals, please prepare to bring forth this year's potential graduates. We will now move into the presentation of the Ontario Secondary School Diplomas and Certificates and will note any of the following distinctions. The Ontario Scholar has achieved 80% in his or her best six grade 12 courses. Marks up to and including second semester midterm are used in the calculations. Students who have up to 2 years have 2 years to achieve this. Any advanced placement certificate is given to a student who has completed their final exam in a designated advanced placement course, potentially allowing students to earn university credits and college credits. A certificate is given to students who have successfully completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Youth Program and have accumulated apprenticeship hours through our cooperative education program. The French Immersion Certificate recognizes students who have earned 10 specific French Immersion credits throughout their high school career. The Diploma d'études en langue française, also referred to as DELF, recognizes students with a diploma in French language studies awarded by the French Ministry of National Education. The DELF evaluates skills in four areas: oral comprehension, oral expression, written comprehension, and written expression. The Specialist High Skills Major Program offers students the opportunity to explore a specific job sector or career interest. Students will acquire the skills and experience that will assist them in their post-secondary pathways, including apprenticeship training, college, university, and workplace. At this time, I will start calling the graduates up. Dylan Alberts. Dylan will be exploring career opportunities through employment. Eric Arnone. Eric is an Ontario Scholar. Go ahead. He's completed the Chisholm Transportation Program, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and the St. Ignatius Music Award. Automotive, bodywork, and apprenticeship for September. Michael Arnone. Michael is an Ontario Scholar. Will be attending Lakehead University in the Business Marketing Program. Megan Arpin. Megan is an Ontario Scholar, returning for further studies at St. Ignatius. Teresa Arroyo Zeglet. Teresa is an Ontario Scholar and will be attending Confederation College in the Environmental Technician Program. Sean Ashcroft. Sean has completed the Chisholm Program in Transportation and has also received an Ontario Youth Apprenticeship. He's exploring career opportunities in policing. Emma Asselstein will be attending Lakehead University in the Political Science Pre-Law Program. Ethan Asselstein. Ethan is an Ontario Scholar, will be receiving the St. Ignatius Religious Education and Family Life Unit Award, and will be attending Lakehead University taking chemistry with concentration in medical sciences. Kira Agruso. Kira will be receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award and will be attending Lakehead University in the General Arts. Caleb Atkinson. Caleb has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program and will be exploring career opportunities through employment. Morgan Ballon. Morgan will be attending Confederation College in the Pre-Aviation Technology Program. Charlie Barton. Charlie is an Ontario Scholar and will be attending Lakehead University studying Electrical Engineering. Jonathan Bocage. Jonathan will be attending Lakehead University studying Kinesiology. Riley Bogard. Riley is an Ontario Scholar, has completed the DELF exam, and will be attending Lakehead University in Business and Accounting. Tia Balcamino. Tia is an Ontario Scholar, is receiving the St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, and will be attending Lakehead University in Political Science Pre-Law. Matthew Belda-Wright. Matthew will be returning to St. Ignatius for further studies and football. Gerline Bueller. She's an Ontario scholar and will be attending Lakehead University in Political Science pre-law program. Nicholas Biesenthal. Nicholas is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, the DELF exam, and has completed Specialist High School's major in Arts and Culture. He will be attending Lakehead University in the Concurrent Education Intermediate Senior Outdoor Recreation program. Madison Blackwood. Madison is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, the DELF exam, and will be attending Lakehead University to study nursing. Edric Bliski. Edric is an Ontario scholar, is receiving the St. Ignatius Recognition Award, and will be attending Lakehead University in Business Finance. Sarah Bottenfield. Sarah is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, the DELF exam, and has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. She will be attending Lakehead University in Concurrent Education, Primary Junior, studying Sociology. Hannah Boyd. Hannah will be attending Confederation College in the Early Childhood Education Program. Just hang on. Travis Branch. Travis will be returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Shay Bromley. Shay will be exploring career opportunities through employment. Paige Broughton. Paige is an Ontario scholar, has completed a specialist high school major in health and wellness, and will be attending Confederation College in the Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Courtney Bruce. Courtney is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Chisholm in Arts and Culture, an Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be attending Canadian Career College for massage therapy. Kirsten Buchholz. Kirsten is an Ontario scholar, has completed the DELF exam, will be receiving the St. Ignatius Science Unit Award, and will be attending the University of Guelph in biomedical science. Caitlin Bueller. Caitlin is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Confederation College studying aviation flight management. April Burridge. April is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Advanced Placement Program, has completed the Chisholm Program in Arts and Culture, and will be attending Brock University Concurrent Education Intermediate Senior English. Ace Butler is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Lakehead University studying English. Erich Kambugnason will be studying at Lakehead University in Business Analytics and Information Systems. Olivia Carlos. Olivia will be attending Lakehead University studying psychology. Joshua Karan. Joshua is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Advanced Placement Program, and will be studying software engineering with co-op at Lakehead University. Thomas Cava. Thomas is an Ontario scholar, is receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award, and will be studying electrical engineering technology at Confederation College. Madison Cici. Madison will be studying kinesiology at Lakehead University. Shailen Chernesky. Shailen will be studying psychology at Lakehead University. Lucius Sherrick Little Gash. He's completed the Chisholm Transportation Program Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program and will be working towards an apprenticeship in automotive mechanic industry. Ella Kyoto. Ella has completed the DELF exam and will be studying concurrent education primary junior level in psychology at Lakehead University. Megan Choney. Megan is an Ontario scholar and will be studying business accounting at Lakehead University. McKenna Christie. McKenna is an Ontario scholar and will be studying business, marketing, and pursuing a career in real estate through Confederation College. Esteban Christofferson. Esteban is an Ontario scholar and will be studying physics at Lakehead University. Leanne Chukra. Leanne will be attending Fanshawe College in the Pre-Health Sciences Pathway to Advanced Diplomas and Degrees. Caleb Cochimiglio. Caleb has completed the French Immersion Certificate, has written the DELF exam, and will be studying social work at Confederation College. Nathan Kosiancic. Nathan has completed the Chisholm in Transportation and will be pursuing a linesman apprenticeship. Katie Como. Katie is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, the DELF exam, and the AP English exam. She'll be studying music at Lakehead University. Kaylee Connor. Kaylee is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, the DELF exam, and is receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award. She will be studying Pre-Health Sciences Pathway to Advanced Diplomas and Degrees at Confederation College. Christopher Coppola. Christopher is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Lakehead University in Business Finance. Chandler Costa. Chandler has completed the Chisholm in Transportation and will be returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Emily Cullinan. Emily is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, the DELF exam, and advanced placement. She will be receiving a St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award and will be attending Ottawa University studying biomedical mechanical engineering. Alexis Dawson, Specialist High Skills major in Arts and Culture, completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, will be receiving a St. Ignatius Arts Award, Aramark Award, and returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Grace the Prophetess. Grace is an Ontario scholar, DELF exam participant, will be receiving the St. Ignatius Business Award and St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award. She'll be studying concurrent education, intermediate senior biology at Lakehead University. Nolan DeSando. Nolan is an Ontario scholar and is going into the Tex Firefighter Program in Texas, USA. Caroline DeFelice. Caroline is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Specialist High School major in Health and Wellness, and will be attending Lakehead University to study nursing. Katie Dosen. Katie will be attending Confederation College in the Early Childhood Education Program. Peyton Douglas. Peyton is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate and DELF exam, and will be studying business accounting at Lakehead University. Jesse Dunn. Jesse has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program and will be attending Conasone College for psychology. Olivia Dupuis. Olivia is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Specialist High School major in Health and Wellness, and will be attending Queen's University to study nursing. Ethan Dill. Ethan is an Ontario scholar and will be studying business general management at Lakehead University. Devin Edwards. Devin has completed the specialist high school major in transportation, has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be attending Confederation College in the pre-technology trade stream. Emma Erickson. Emma is an Ontario scholar, has completed specialist high skills in health and wellness. The Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program will be receiving the St. Ignatius Science Unit Award and will be attending Confederation College in primary care paramedics. Alexi Escuega. Alexi will be exploring career opportunities through employment. Destiny Eisner. Destiny is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Schism in Health and Wellness, is receiving the St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, and will be attending Confederation College in Civil Engineering, Technician, and Chemical Engineering. Caitlin Ezard. Caitlin is an Ontario scholar, French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam participant, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be attending Nipissing University Concurrent Education Primary Junior French. Alyssa Fabiano. Alyssa is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam participant, Schism in Health and Wellness, and will be receiving a St. Ignatius Excellence Award, and will be studying nursing at Lakehead University. Lucy Fabiano. Lucy is an Ontario scholar, will be receiving the St. Ignatius Recognition Award, and will be studying at Lakehead University in Concurrent Education Primary Junior Sociology. Vincenzo Fabiano. Vincenzo is an Ontario scholar, has completed Schism in Construction, and has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program. He is going to be returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Lucy Falsino. Lucy is an Ontario scholar and will be studying kinesiology at Lakehead University. Sierra Fidel. Sierra will be studying nursing at Lakehead University. Ethan Fell. Ethan has completed the Schism in Transportation, the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be studying Instrumentation Engineering Technician, Process Automation and Control at Confederation College. Mitchell Fell. Mitchell is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Lakehead University in the Environmental Management Program. Maya Ferris. Maya is an Ontario scholar, is receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award, and will be attending Lakehead University in the nursing program. Grace Fitzpatrick. Grace is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Confederation College studying police foundations. Jackson Fonzo. Jackson is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Confederation College for police foundations. Joseph Foresta. Joseph is an Ontario scholar attending Lakehead University in Concurrent Education Intermediate Senior History. Natalia Fortino. Natalia is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Schism program in Hospitality and Tourism, the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be studying Culinary Management at Confederation College. Jarek Francoeur. Jarek is an Ontario scholar and will be studying environmental management at Lakehead University. Ethan Friesen. Ethan is an Ontario scholar, French Immersion Certificate, a DELF exam participant, a Schism in Health and Wellness, and will be studying Applied Life Sciences at Lakehead University. Paige Fusil. Paige is an Ontario scholar and will be studying business finance at Lakehead University. Karina Gaberlik. Karina is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam, and specialist high skills in health and wellness. She'll be studying nursing at Lakehead. Bianca Gallet. Bianca is receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award and will be attending Humber College to earn her real estate license. Caden Gardner. Caden has the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, will be pursuing an electrical apprenticeship. Carson Goddard. Carson will be attending Confederation College in the Computer Programming Program. Reagan Goddick. Reagan will be studying social work at Lakehead University. Colton Goodmurphy. Colton has completed the specialist high school major in transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and he will be working towards an apprenticeship in the Carpenters Local Union 57. Jordan Graham. Jordan is an Ontario scholar, is receiving the St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, and will be studying psychology at Lakehead University. Austin Green. Austin will be pursuing an apprenticeship in HVAC. Shayla Gregorchuk Tremblay. She will be receiving an Aramark Award and will be attending Confederation College in the Social Work Program. Dante Gwidlin. Dante will be pursuing an apprenticeship in carpentry. Katie Hack. Katie is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Queen's University in the Bachelor of Science Honours Program. Caden Halstead. French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam participant, and will be earning a welding apprenticeship with Sheet Metal Workers Union. Madison Hanlon-Smith. Madison is an Ontario scholar exploring career opportunities through employment. Aaron Happonen. Aaron will be attending Lakehead University in psychology. Jory Hay. Jory will be studying electrical engineering technology at Confederation College. Isabel Hayden. Isabel has completed CHISM in transportation, has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be studying early childhood education at Confederation College. Taylor Hayes. Taylor is an Ontario scholar, has completed the CHISM in health and wellness, and will be attending Lakehead University, studying biology with a concentration in neuroscience. Aiden Helke. Aiden will be attending Lakehead University in mechatronics engineering with a co-op. Isaac Hill. Isaac is an Ontario scholar, has completed the CHISM in transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, will be receiving the St. Ignatius Mathematics Unit Award, the St. Ignatius Religious Education and Family Life Unit Award, Confederation College, Electrical Engineering and Technology. Thomas Hill, Ontario scholar, completed the CHISM Transportation Program, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, has earned the St. Ignatius Technology Unit Award, and will be pursuing an automotive apprenticeship. Bethany Hintz. Bethany will be receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award and will be studying at Lakehead University in Business and Human Resources. Olivia Holland. Olivia is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Chisholm in Transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be studying at Confederation College, taking welding techniques. Kaylee Hersu. Kaylee is an Ontario scholar, will be studying Bachelor of Science in Nursing at Confederation College. Kira Hubbard. Kira has completed the Chisholm program in Arts and Culture, will be attending Mohawk College, the 3D animation program. Jordan Humanik. Jordan is an Ontario scholar, has completed the French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam, advanced placement. She is earning a Moderns Unit Award, Drama Unit Award, and will be attending Lakehead University in Concurrent Education, Intermediate Senior English. Julia Hunter. Julia is an Ontario scholar. Julia is earning a St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award and will be attending Lakehead University studying business marketing. Emmanuel Hurtubise. Emmanuel is an Ontario scholar, has completed his French Immersion Certificate, and is receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award. He'll be studying kinesiology at Lakehead University. Matthew Iketa. Matthew is an Ontario scholar, has completed the DELF exam and the advanced placement. He is receiving an Academic Excellence Award and will be attending University of Toronto Computer Engineering. David Iwanishin. David will be attending Confederation College, Electrical Engineering Technology. Jenna Jackson. Jenna is receiving the St. Ignatius Unit Award in Physical Education and will be attending Sioux College, Sports Administration. Ashley Johnson. Ashley has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program and will be taking a gap year. Riley Johnstone. Riley is an Ontario scholar and will be receiving a St. Ignatius Recognition Award, and she will be studying psychology at Lakehead University. Josh Julian. Josh will be receiving the Ontario Secondary School Certificate, will be attending Confederation College in the Community Integration through Cooperative Education Program. Lena Kaiser Sessions. She's an Ontario scholar and will be attending Confederation College in the Pre-Health Sciences to advance diplomas and degrees. Hannah Kisick. Hannah will be attending Lakehead University studying social work. Ezra Koester. Ezra is an Ontario scholar and will be studying social work at Lakehead University. Tyler Coronin. Tyler is an Ontario scholar and will be studying business and accounting at Lakehead University. Callie Koch. Callie is an Ontario scholar and will be attending Fleming College in Geological Technician Program. Alyssa Kreiner. Alyssa will be studying psychology at Lakehead University. Vashlin Quandavens Boucher-Lagarde is an Ontario scholar, has completed the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and will be studying welding techniques at Confederation College. Hold up. Wait. Sorry. My partner hasn't come up. I'm waiting for Ms. Papich, but we're going to do it. I can continue. Ethan Labar. Ethan is receiving the St. Ignatius Student Services Award and will be exploring career opportunities through employment. Evan Lakimia. Evan is an Ontario scholar playing hockey in Saskatchewan.
I'm supposed to start at the M's. These are L's.
That's why it threw me off.
Thrown off my system. I don't have a card.
Mr. Carpino.
Mr. Carpino, what's your card?
Oh. I'm going to read it. Okay, buddy. Jada Lang, studying nursing at Confederation College. I apologize, Jada.
Now I don't even start at the L's.
L's, L's.
Hi, Maria.
Maria LaPlante. Maria will be receiving an Ontario Secondary School Certificate and will be attending Confederation College Community Integration through Cooperative Education. Nicole Lauren is an Ontario Scholar with an Advanced Placement St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award. She'll be attending Lincoln University Concurrent Education, Intermediate Senior Biology and Chemistry. Haley Lawson is an Ontario Scholar and will be attending Lakehead University Concurrent Education P2J in Women's Studies. Myla Lawson is an Ontario Scholar, it's a French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam participant, and the St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award. She'll be attending Lakehead University with a dual degree in Chemical Engineering with a co-op and a Master's in Business and Administration. Lucas Lazari is exploring career opportunities through employment. Tao Li will be attending Confederation College, Electrical Engineering Technology. Nathan Lepore will be attending the Central Baptist College in Business Management. Katrina Long is an Ontario Scholar, SHSM, Health and Wellness, Lakehead University, Kinesiology. Adam Lucci's is attending Confederation College in Practical Nursing. Sebastian Lusinski is exploring educational and career opportunities through employment. Hi, Brock. Brock McKenzie is Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Humber College Heating, Refrigeration, and Air Conditioning Technician. Gabriel McRae will be attending Confederation College in Carpentry Renovation Techniques. Donovan Manpaw is an Ontario Scholar, will be attending Lakehead University in Biology and Chemistry. Chloe Millette is an Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Hospitality and Tourism, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, will be attending Confederation College in Recreation Therapy. Spencer Malosh is returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Angelina Macuso, Specialist High Skills Major in Hospitality and Tourism, will be attending Confederation College in Culinary Management. Sarah Mann is an Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, a DELF exam participant, and will be attending Lakehead University Concurrent Education PJ Psychology. Lucas Marchese is an Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Construction, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, and the St. Ignatius Technological Studies Award. He'll be attending the TEX Firefighter Program in Texas, USA. Anastasia Massey is a French Immersion Certificate with DELF exam participant, will be attending Confederation College in Instrumentation Technician, Process Automation and Control. Logan Morrow is an Ontario Scholar, Specialist High School Majors in Transportation, Confederation College Welding Techniques. Jenna Mazan, Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, DELF exam participant, will be attending Lakehead University to study Business Accounting. Abigail Mazuka is an Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness, Lakehead University Nursing. Jorgen McDevitt is French Immersion Certificate, DELF Exam Participant, Specialist High Skills Major Construction, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, exploring career opportunities with an industrial electrician. Emery McKay is attending Confederation College Pre-Technology Trade Stream. Jack McLeod, Lakehead University Environmental Management. Lily McLeod, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Exploring Career Opportunities in the Trades. Kenna McCrory, Ontario Scholar, will be studying nursing at Lakehead University. Kira Meekin, Ontario Scholar, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, will be studying kinesiology at Lakehead University. Sloan Melchiori is an Ontario Scholar, Western University Medical Sciences, Physiology and Pharmacology. Moira Menard is an Ontario Scholar, French Certificate, French Immersion Certificate, DELF Exam Participant, and the St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, who is studying nursing at Lakehead University. Horizon Mendewagen will be attending Confederation College for Developmental Services Worker. Samuel Mendoza, Specialist High Skills Major in Construction, returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Cody Michon. Cody is exploring career opportunities through employment. Kiara Migliazza is an Ontario Scholar, St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, Lakehead University Concurrent Education, PJ Psychology. Max Mikas, Lakehead University Business Marketing. Destiny Miller is an Ontario Scholar, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Confederation College, Early Childhood Education. Kidan Modi is an Ontario Scholar, attending Toronto Metropolitan University in Business Management. Kiki Moore is an Ontario Scholar, Specialist High School Major Construction, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, is awarded the Aramark Award, the St. Ignatius Moderns Award, the St. Ignatius Social Science Award, and will be attending Confederation College and Pre-Technology Trades Stream. Mason Moselle will be pursuing a plumbing apprenticeship. Emma Mueller is exploring career opportunities through employment. Nolan Neal will be attending Confederation College for academic upgrading. Julian Neufeld, French Immersion Certificate, DELF Exam Participant, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, will be attending Confederation College for Mechanical Techniques. Isabella Neves is an Ontario Scholar, a DELF Exam Participant, will be attending Lakehead University in Applied Life Sciences with a concentration in Biomedical Science. Christopher Negro will be attending Lakehead University for Kinesiology. Sarah Okerlund is an Ontario Scholar, Confederation College Pre-Health Sciences, Pathway to Advanced Diplomas and Degrees. Jeffrey Otto will be attending Lakehead University Business Marketing. Emily Paulo, Ontario Scholar, will be attending Confederation College in Nursing for a Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Dylan Papa will be returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Ashton Parker, Specialist High Skills Major in Transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Anna Parkery will be attending Lakehead University in Business Marketing. Nathan Peace is an Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, DELF Exam Participant, and a St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award. Will be attending King's University in Edmonton, Alberta, in Interdisciplinary Studies. Madison Peterson is an Ontario Scholar, Canadian Armed Forces, studying at Lakehead University, Concurrent Education, PG Sociology. Andrew Pepler, Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, will be attending Confederation College for Welding Techniques. Mikey Pereira is an Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, pursuing an apprenticeship in welding. Braden Peachinen, attending the Saint is awarded the St. Ignatius Recognition Award and is attending Lakehead University in biology with a concentration in animal studies. Abigail Pilon is a Delph exam participant studying nursing at Lakehead University. Johnny Power, returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Noah Power will be attending Confederation College Electronics Engineering Technician for Computers. Zoe Power, Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delph exam participant, will be attending St. Francis Xavier University for Human Kinetics. Victor Pucci is awarded the St. Ignatius Recognition Award. He'll be attending Lake University Electrical Engineering with Co-op. Jordan Pitala, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, the Aramark Award, will be attending Confederation College Dental Assisting Levels 1 and 2. Dominic Kuresima, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Rayette Rahman is an Ontario Scholar, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, attending the University of Manitoba in General Science. Dante Riccio is an Ontario Scholar, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, will be studying chemistry at Lakehead University. Evan Robert, French Immersion Certificate, Delph exam participant, will study biology with a concentration in animal science at Lakehead University. Tia Robert, French Immersion Certificate, Delph exam participant, will be studying social work at Lakehead University. Lydia Rocco, Specialist High Skills Major in Arts and Culture, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, Confederation College and Film Production. Kyle Rogers, Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Construction, Confederation College Pre-Service Firefighting Education and Training. Sydney Roberto is an Ontario Scholar, will be studying Computer Engineering with Co-op at the University of Ottawa. Sam Sargent. Sam Sargent, Ontario Scholar, will study business at Confederation College. Ben Savor will be studying career opportunities through employment. Caleb Sawatsky Calder, Specialist High Skills Major in Arts and Culture, exploring career opportunities with employment with hopes to attend the Vancouver Film School. Oh, really nice to see you. Rhea Scully is an Ontario Scholar, Delph exam participant, Advanced Placement, St. Ignatius Mathematics Award, St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, will be attending the University of Waterloo in Biomedical Engineering. Bella Serafini, Specialist High Skills Major, Health and Wellness, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, will be studying at the Canadian Career College for Massage Therapy. Mohamed Shabana is an Ontario Scholar, a Specialist High Skills Major in Health and Wellness, will be studying Kinesiology at Lakehead University. Delaney Schaefer is an Ontario Scholar, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, pursuing a Diploma in Equine Massage Therapy. Alexa Shearer, French Immersion Certificate, Delph Exam Participant, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, will be studying Business Marketing at Lakehead University. Ethan Sherwood will be returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Nick Shindak, Specialist High Skills Major in Transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Confederation College Welding Techniques. Drayden Cyber, Specialist High Skilled Major in Transportation, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Exploring Career Opportunities Through Employment. Chad Smith, Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delph Exam Participant, Advanced Placement, St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, Lakehead University, Civil Engineering. Lincoln Smiley is an Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delph Exam Participant, Specialist High Skills Major, Health and Wellness, studying nursing at Lakehead University. Fernanda Soto Valenzuela Ontario Scholar, Delft Exam Participant, Special High Skills Major in Health and Wellness, will be studying Kinesiology at Lakehead University. Thomas Sousa, Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Construction, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, pursuing an electrical apprenticeship. Gavin St. Amand, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, the Aramark Award, exploring career opportunities through employment with plans to pursue a millwright apprenticeship. Taya St. Jean, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, Lakehead University, Business Finance. Caitlin Stewart, Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delft Exam Participant, St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, Lakehead University, Business Finance. Anna Stickle will be studying biology with a concentration in animal science at Lakehead University. Victoria Stray is an Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delft Exam Participant, Lakehead University Applied Life Sciences with a concentration in biomedical sciences. Adam Strickland is a French Immersion Certificate, Delft Exam Participant, Lakehead University Political Science Pre-Law. Connor Stubbs is an Ontario Scholar, Delft Exam Participant, Advanced Placement, St. Ignatius Computers Award, St. Ignatius Student Services Award, St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Awards. Will be studying Honors Physics and Astronomy at the University of Waterloo. Alyssa Sullivan, Ontario Scholar, Delft Exam Participant, Specialist High Skills Major with Health and Wellness, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, Lakehead University, General Arts. Eric Sindel, Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skill Major, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, Confederation College Aviation Technician, Aircraft Maintenance. Gage Sprickerhoff, Specialist High Skills Major in Construction, pursuing a construction apprenticeship through the Canadian Armed Forces. Charlotte Sutton is a St. Ignatius Recognition Award winner, will be attending Wilfrid Laurier University in Psychology and Neuroscience. Cora Taipala, Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major in Arts and Culture, will be attending Lakehead University Concurrent Education PJ Aboriginal Education. Akira Tatabi, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, Lakehead University Nursing. Matty Tito, Specialist High Skills Major, Construction, pursuing an apprenticeship as a heavy equipment mechanic. Blessing Tara Weppe, Ontario Scholars, Delft Exam Participant, St. Ignatius Academic Excellence Award, will be studying Applied Life Sciences with a concentration in Biomedical Science at Lakehead University. Nadia Tozo is an Ontario Scholar, Lakehead University Concurrent Education PJ English. Mariana Vargas Gonzalez, Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delft Exam Participant, Advanced Placement, St. Ignatius Social Science Award, St. Ignatius Academic of Excellence Award, Lakehead University Anthropology. Anthony Vatamanelu, Lakehead University, Chemical Engineering. Maya Venn, will be attending Confederation College in Interactive Media Development. Olivia Verardo is an Ontario Scholar studying at Lakehead University for Psychology. Tiana Vigen is an Ontario Scholar, a Delft Exam Participant, will be studying Civil Engineering at Lakehead University. Braden von Munchausen is an Ontario Scholar, will be studying Career Opportunities Through Employment. Haley Wallace is exploring Career Opportunities Through Employment. Connor Walters is an Ontario Scholar, French Immersion Certificate, Delft Exam Participant, Specialist High Skills Major Construction, Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, will be studying at Niagara and Halton Skills Trade Academy G2 and G3 Gas Fitting. Paisley Ward Ogama will be attending Confederation College in Pre-Health Sciences, Pathway to Advanced Diplomas and Degrees. Maya Weaver will be studying nursing at Confederation College. Bradley Werstedt, Ontario Scholar, returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Aaron Whipple is an Ontario Scholar, Lake University, nursing. Abby White, she's exploring career opportunities through employment. Gunnar White, St. Ignatius Physical Education Award, returning to St. Ignatius for further studies. Marcus Zapatelli is an Ontario Scholar, Specialist High Skills Major, Transportation, Ontario Youth Program, pursuing an apprenticeship in heavy-duty equipment. Tyler Robinson, St. Ignatius Recognition Award, Football Athletic Scholarship, University of British Columbia, Psychology. Graduates, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your graduating class of 2023.
Please be seated. We have now come to a very special part of our program. Each year, the students in the graduating class select a classmate to represent them. It is now my pleasure to introduce the chosen valedictorian for the St. Ignatius graduating class of 2023. I would like to invite Chad Smith to come forward to share his valedictory address.
Good evening, everyone. I'm honored to welcome Reverend Bishop Colley, members of the Catholic School Board, trustees, school administration, honored guests, and presenters. I would also like to express my sincere gratitude to all of the parents and guardians, teachers and friends in the audience, as well as those watching over the live stream, who have helped us graduates reach this significant point in our lives. And I would most certainly like to express my thank yous to my fellow classmates who have given me this tremendous opportunity. I stand before you today filled with pride and honor to be speaking on behalf of St. Ignatius's graduating class of 2023. Today is a day that us graduates have eagerly awaited since our 3-foot-tall, wide-eyed selves began our first day of kindergarten 13 years ago. High school graduation may be looked at as the end of a journey, but it should not be regarded as a destination. It represents, rather, a significant milestone in each one of our lives. As graduates of St. Ignatius High School, we are encouraged to live according to strong morals and virtues of goodness. One of these virtues that I find to be admirable, as well as very fitting to our occasion tonight, is gratitude. Oprah Winfrey once said, "Be thankful for what you have, and you'll end up having more. If you focus on what you do not have, you will never have enough." It is important to look at life through this lens and to always be appreciative and grateful for what is presented to us. For that reason, I would like to take this opportunity to speak for the entire graduating class in thanking all of those who have played a significant role in our journeys and have contributed to our accomplishments. It is essential to begin by expressing our deepest gratitude to our parents and guardians. Being a parent involves caring, guiding, and supporting teenagers who do not always want or appreciate it, and often just want to be left alone so we can waste time on our phones. Without our parents or guardians, none of us would be here today, and we most certainly would not be the individuals who we have become. From the time that we are born, our parents have placed our happiness and well-being at the forefront of their lives. In my house, much like many others, this involved reading to me, getting me involved in sports, helping me with my studies, playing mini sticks with my brother and I, and more recently, letting me borrow the car. Parents and guardians, the countless sacrifices that you make most certainly do not go unnoticed. Your selfless dedication has shaped us into the individuals that we have become. Through your love, care, and guidance, you have instilled in us values, principles, and a strong sense of character. You have always been there to make sure that we dream big and try to live up to these dreams, but also to ground us when we go beyond reason. I remember the first time I watched a Batman movie. Once it finished, I turned to my mom and I said, "Mom, when I grow up, I'm gonna be Batman." She looked back at me and she said, "Chad, grow up, you graduate in a couple weeks." On behalf of all my fellow graduates, thank you, parents and guardians, for being our unwavering pillars of support and our number one role models. Teachers, much like our parents, have been our guiding lights throughout our high school journey. I believe that the philosophy of roots and wings perfectly encapsulates the role that our teachers have played in shaping our character throughout our years of high school. When I talk about roots, I am referring to the sense of belonging and comfort that our teachers have instilled in us and built in our high school community over the years. Not only have our teachers helped us build the sense of community, but all of the staff members at St. Ignatius. Our front office and administration, ensuring that everything behind the scenes runs smoothly. Our SSPs, school chaplain, and social workers who cater to the individual needs of every student. Our coaches who have taught us lessons beyond the typical classroom setting. And of course, our beloved custodians who ensure that the school is always a safe and clean learning space. You've created a warm and welcoming environment where we have been encouraged to challenge ourselves, explore our passions, and discover our true identities. The words of the prayer of St. Ignatius ultimately encourage us to give but not count the cost, to labor but to ask for no reward. Our teachers and staff members in our school community have always demonstrated these concepts. Working tirelessly to ensure our students are taken care of without looking for anything in return. In doing so, you have taught us and encouraged us to live our lives in the same way, hopefully helping others just as you have helped us. Moreover, our teachers have provided us with the wings that we need to soar to new heights. You have recognized the importance of autonomy, and you have given us the courage to take risks and embrace new challenges. We recognize the contributions of both Mr. Oster and Ms. Corbett, who will be taking on a different role after this year. Mr. Oster will be exploring new parts of the education world, becoming a new principal of St. Vincent. Ms. Corbett will be exploring life outside of education and retiring. Much like us graduates, these two individuals will be leaving St. Ignatius and moving on to new adventures. We wish them all the best. All of our teachers have given us something to remember them by, whether it be Mr. Lametti's peg leg that he walked around on for half the year, Ms. Bedotto's infamous phrase, "Go team," Mr. Bassett's love for teasing and playing pranks, and Mr. Riley McWhirter constantly reminding everyone that our hair will never be quite as nice as his. Beyond the classroom, you have served as mentors and trusted confidants, listening to our concerns, celebrating our achievements, and offering guidance in moments of uncertainty. Your passion for teaching and unwavering belief in our potential has shaped us into the individuals we are today, and we extend our greatest appreciation to each and every one of you for being a part of our high school journey. While our parents, guardians, and teachers have been supporting us in the right direction, our friends have also helped us to explore some of the others. Together, we have shared countless unforgettable memories over the span of our high school years, all the way back to the first time many of us met at grade 8 barbecue and supported each other through the nerve-wracking first day of grade 9. That dire Thursday that our March break was extended by 2 weeks and then a little longer, but even in the face of the challenging and confusing times brought on by COVID-19, we found strength and reassurance in our friendships, supporting one another through it all. All of the pep rallies, dances, and quiz nights, Monroe's parking lot cookout, and all of the sunny days spent out on the field. Soon, we will also share in the milestone that is prom. Whether our friendships have endured to this day, or if we have taken our separate paths, each and every friend we have made has taught us valuable lessons, such as the importance of your own happiness, how other people can change, or maybe even realizing that you need to make a change to yourself. Friendship is an essential part of high school, and indeed, life as a whole. In times of joy, our friends have been the ones with whom we have laughed and celebrated. In times of hardship, they have offered a shoulder to lean on, an empathetic ear to listen, and words of encouragement to uplift our spirits. Friends, you have been the ones who have shared and seen us through our successes and our failures, and through your presence, you have enriched our lives immeasurably. Fellow graduates, as we stand on the cusp of new beginnings, we carry with us valuable lessons, cherished friendships, and lasting memories from our time at St. Ignatius. These are the treasures that we have acquired along the way. Equally important is the notion of leaving a positive impact behind us. When we depart from this place, let us strive to be remembered for the moments we shared with others and the contributions that we have made to our school community. Let us be grateful for our experiences and our knowledge gained during our time in St. Ignatius, and hopefully we have left behind a legacy that inspires and uplifts those who follow in our footsteps. As we speak of moving forward, I'm sure everyone has been asked many times in the past few months, what are you going to school for, or what do you want to be when you grow up? The more important question that I propose to you right now is not what do you want to be when you grow up, but rather who do you want to be? This subtle change in perspective prompts us to base our future plans and identities on our true selves rather than merely our achievements or our job titles. It reminds us that our character and values are something that we are the masters of and have complete control over. While achieving success and reaching our goals is important and admirable, it is meaningless if we do not find happiness and fulfillment in doing so, while also being grateful for what we have rather than envious of what we do not. I recently went on a trip with a close group of friends. During one particular moment, my friend Dom's father, Joe Charisma, turned to us and said, "This is what life is all about. Being able to put yourselves and those you love in a position where you can experience true happiness." These words really stuck with me. Life is enjoyable when you're in a position to experience moments like this. However, it is even more enjoyable when you work hard and are grateful for what is in front of you. Fellow graduates, I implore each and every one of you to work as hard as possible in anything you do. By doing so, you will position yourselves to create moments of happiness and joy for those and the ones you love. I wish you all to set yourselves up with lives that are abundant in joy, whether that be through meaningful relationships, a fulfilling career, or making a positive impact in your communities. So let us embark on this journey of happiness and gratitude, for it is in this pursuit that we will not only transform our lives, but the lives of all those around us. Thank you very much, good luck, and congratulations to the St. Ignatius graduating class of 2023.
Thank you, Chad. At this time, I invite Mr. McWhorter for some parting words.
Thank you again, Mr. Oster. As Chad had mentioned in his speech already, after 38 years in education, one of our teachers, Mrs. Corbett, has made the difficult decision to retire. During her career, Mrs. Corbett has been a true champion for both Catholic education and St. Ignatius High School. She has touched the lives of thousands of students and inspired many of them to join the teaching profession, some of whom she works with today. She often says that teaching is her vocation, not her job. And those of us who know her and work with her know that she is just as passionate about teaching students today as she was 20 years ago. A true professional and someone on our staff who is truly irreplaceable. On behalf of the staff and students, I would like to say thank you for your commitment these past 38 years, and we would like to wish you all the best in your retirement. You will be missed. Please join me in showing our appreciation for Mrs. Corbett.
I would like to invite Peyton Douglas and Jordan Humanick on stage for a special musical presentation called Fall on Me.
Close my eyes.
Thank you, Peyton and Jordan, for that beautiful song. At this time, I would like to take a moment to thank the many people who have helped make this evening so special. Thank you to all of the presenters from our community who took time out of their busy schedules to join us this evening. Your support of our school and of Catholic education is greatly appreciated. Thank you to our dignitaries and guests from the school board for joining us in this celebration. Thank you to all who have contributed to our graduation ceremony in any way this evening, and to the staff of the auditorium for their assistance. This truly is a world-class facility. I would like to thank the Student Services Department for coordinating our graduation this evening, the members of our graduation committee, and all the staff and students whose long hours of hard work have made this entire day, from the Mass to the convocation, a special day to remember. I would like to thank all of you for your endless contributions in helping these students to achieve their success and for joining us to celebrate them tonight. Lastly, I would like to extend best wishes and congratulations to all of our graduates. Best wishes in all of your future endeavors. Graduates, you're asked to follow the directions of the marshals as you leave the stage and are reminded that you have approximately 20 minutes for photos before you return to the mezzanine level using the left staircase to return your gowns. We kindly ask all guests to exit the mezzanine level and meet the graduates on the main floor or outside to facilitate the gown return. Thank you very much, and good evening.